A local group is working to save abused dogs that were shot, poisoned, and hit by cars. News 13's Stephanie Bachara shows us how they've already rescued dozens but want to save even more.
Disposing of a dog like they're a piece of trash is unacceptable.
This is the Redlands in South Florida, where Poodle and Pooch Rescue from Central Florida rescued over 50 abandoned dogs.
I watched a woman drive to the end of a road, and she opened up her door, pushed the dogs out, closed the door, and drove off. And the dogs were running after her, trying to get back to her vehicle.
Some of the pets rescued were actually in pretty bad shape. Honey here was fed metal, and we know this because x-rays show that metal shards were mixed with food in her intestines.
Another dog was shot in the eye with a pellet gun. Three puppies had their tails cut off, and others were badly beaten.
I've been rescuing dogs since I was 9 years old, and I'm 51 now, and I've never seen a situation like this before, ever.
The nonprofit teamed up with a group of women in the Redlands who help feed the dogs, but don't have the resources to do much more than that.
There are many people that come to Miami-Dade to surrender their dogs there, and Miami-Dade Animal Shelter turns them away because they're either too full. They are working to become a no-kill shelter. And with that, you're not euthanizing dogs, so, you know, the capacity to take more dogs on is, you know, impossible.
The work doesn't end there. They've committed to saving 100 dogs. At this point, they have 27 more to go. All of this in addition to their local efforts here. In Orange County, Stephanie Bachara, News 13.
A spokesperson for Miami-Dade Animal Services says they regularly patrol and respond to calls in the Redlands. They claim that in the past 3 years, more than 2,000 strays have been picked up and over 500 cruelty cases have been handled in the southern part of the county. For information on fostering or adopting, check out our website, mynews13.com.